How to Learn Anatomy, 5 DOS and 5 Donuts. So, do number one, do understand the role that anatomy is going to play in your figure drawings, because it's not the case that you just learn a bunch of where muscles start and end and stuff like that, and then your figure drawings look amazing. Anatomy is part of a bigger machine of skills. And so there's gesture, there's simplifying your values into interesting shapes, there's form, all these other skills, and anatomy feeds into that. So when you're starting out, you just need basic anatomy. So instead of learning all the complexity of the pelvis is such a crazy shape. You don't need that when you're starting out, you're trying to figure out the basics of gesture drawing, you're trying to figure out the basics of form and stuff like that. Just a very simple idea of the pelvis, a very simple idea of this egg-shaped rib cage, very similar idea of the head. You learn some landmarks to help you figure out where those are and what their angles are. And that is going to help you so much. And now anatomy is feeding into all your other skills. If I do say so myself, the best way to learn that, in my opinion, is with the Fresh Eyes Challenge. It really boils things down to just the things that you need. We've just made this web-based app, so it's much easier now to play around with a 2D model. If anyone's done the challenge, leave a comment below, because it sounds very big-headed when I say it's awesome, so maybe you can say it's awesome for me. The next stage then is to start to learn about muscle groups. So you might not need to know all the different extensor muscles of the forearm or the details of each quadricep muscle, but you can start to look at the bigger group and identify them. On the thighs, you might start to see the bigger group of the quadriceps separated from the inner thigh by the sartorius. This is kind of intermediate level anatomy. I've been doing like sketches of arms, for example, and you can see there's a little bit of anatomy in there. This level of anatomy feeds into these kinds of sketches. Then you can move on to more advanced anatomy. Then you can start to learn about the different extensor muscles, the details of the different quadriceps. You can get into more detailed stuff. So to go along with that, the first don't is don't just try and memorize anatomy. Speaking from experience, I've tried this. Who would be crazy enough to try and memorize anatomy, fail, and then just try again and fail and try again? Who would do that? That would be ridiculous, right? That's like trying to learn a language by opening a dictionary and just reading all the words. You learn a language by learning the grammar. The grammar of figure drawing is the stuff that unifies what we're seeing, the gesture, the simplification of the values. And then you learn just enough anatomy to inform those skills. What a great analogy. Wow. So the second do is you are going to need resources to learn anatomy from. It's good to have some anatomy books if you can get some. And I like the Valerie Winslow book. I think it's really practical and down to earth. Also really practical is the Anatomy for Sculptors book, but there's loads of really good anatomy books out there. Also useful is to see some anatomy videos, like here on YouTube, Proco has good videos, and we're going to be coming out with more anatomy videos too. And then it's good to have some 3D models. The really cool thing with 3D models, obviously the books have these flat diagrams, and often people start thinking about anatomy in this flat way because of that. But a 3D model is cool because you're going to be able to turn it around and see the 3D form. And I really like this 3D model. It's freely available online from Scott Breton. Why do I love it so much? Because this is an actual physical model, but this is from 3D Total, and a lot of anatomy poses are like this. This is nicely sculpted and stuff, but it's like this really boring pose. His pose is really designed for artists. It's a very gestural pose. It's got a weight-bearing leg, which pushes up the pelvis a little bit on one side, makes a little bit of squash and stretch in the torso, a raised leg, a bent leg. There's some pronation of an arm, there's some supination of an arm, there's a bent arm, there's a raised arm. Everything we're going to want to see. How do the muscles stretch up when the arm is raised? How do the forearms turn over when pronated? These things are brought out in this 3D model, and that is really thoughtful of him and really, really cool. Another type of resource is the physical model, like I said. So there's this one from 3D Total, which is it's good. It's nicely sculpted and stuff like that. I do have a couple of issues with it, which I'll talk about another time. But I also really, really like, you can get, I haven't put this together yet and glued it and added the arms, but you can get the Scott Breton model 3D printed by him as well. So I'll leave a link to that below and I'll talk about that a bit more later. But just being able to like look at the shoulder blade and the arm and see how the pronation works like right here in my hands is very interesting and useful. Not essential. You can learn anatomy without a physical model, but if you can get one, it's a nice addition. So the second don't is don't rely on one resource or one type of resource, right? So I like the book, but I don't just study from this book. So I talked about those other, the 3D models and whatnot as well. There's also other resources. So there's medical resources. These are a little bit tricky because their purpose is different, right? They're interested in something else. So they can sometimes be too comprehensive. But I've learned a lot from watching this one doctor on YouTube. He just grabs, he looks tired, he's in a hospital, he just grabs a skeleton model and just explains something about anatomy. I also have learned a lot from certain bodybuilding videos because bodybuilders are interested in the surface forms just like we artists are. They're interested as well in like, what does the muscle do? Because they want to like lift weight or whatever to build that specific muscle. The cons are one, it's one body type, right? It's kind of sometimes disproportionately large muscles and very little, like unusually little amount of fat. So it's one body type. And also weirdly, sometimes the anatomy info is good, but the actual fitness tips are really, really bad. So you gotta be careful with that. So do number three is do train to construct the anatomy. So start from drawing the bone, then add each muscle, drawing it on top. So for example, if you have a book, there's lots of resources that have this where you're gonna have the same angle, you're gonna have the bone, and then one muscle added, another muscle added. And that's gonna help you to do this exercise for, in this case, building up the extensor muscles on the forearm and constructing them from nothing, which is really cool. If you can draw them out, it's a really good exercise. If you can sculpt them, that is also a really good exercise. And that's what this Breton model that I was talking about before, that's what it's designed for. So it comes with plasticine and you can refer to, he's got like a course that comes with it and you refer to the detailed 3D models and build the plasticine on top. I found it really interesting and fun. So I got this model last year and I did it with my mum's.
Nanny put it. What's that?
No.
So it's not essential to sculpt the anatomy, but it's a nice addition, right? But with an anatomy, it's so good to triangulate, to come at it from different angles. And this is another really good angle to come at it from. Full transparency, I got sent this version of the model for free. I bought the first one last year, but this one, I got it for free. But I'm not being paid anything to promote it. There's no affiliate links or anything like that. There is a discount code for you if you are interested in it. So I'll put the details of that below. So don't ignore fat. A lot of the resources we've talked about really focus on muscle and bone, and then just have maybe one page about fat or don't talk about fat at all. And fat is a huge part of what we're seeing, right? It smooths the surface, obviously, but it does so to a different extent in different parts of the figure. So there's more fat on the upper arm than the forearm, more on the forearm than the hand, for example. Also, it affects, not just smooths out, but it also creates its own forms on the surface of the figure. So it's very important and useful, I think, to draw people with different body types to get used to that. In terms of resources, there aren't that many about fat, but one that, so Jake Spicer's book has a bit about it. The BAMS, Godfrey BAMS book has something about it. But the book that's probably most comprehensive is this one. Morpho has a series. Oh, there's a series of anatomy books called Morpho. It's a tiny little book. They printed it so small. It's mostly like example drawings, but it shows you the forms that fat can create on the figure. So if you are interested in that, that's a useful resource. So do trace the anatomy onto models. This is pretty hard, but once you start to get used to the anatomy, you feel like you've got a good handle on it. Next, you're going to want to try and see it in actual people, right? And one way to do that, to practice that, is to get a reference photo and try and trace either with tracing paper or digitally, figure out where the bones are and then start to build the musculature on top of that, tracing it onto an actual reference photo. And one tip, if you do this exercise, one tip I have is especially like you're gonna need, you feel like you need x-ray vision for this, but one thing that can help is, like, let's say you're doing an arm, you can do the same pose as that person with your own arm, and then you can just feel like, oh, there's the bone there, there's the humerus right there, and that's going to help you with that exercise. Don't quit. This is not going to be something that you do a month, you take a month for anatomy, you've learned anatomy. It's something that you slowly build alongside your other skills. So in total, it might take a couple of years to really get a good understanding of anatomy, but you don't have to think about it as this huge project, right? That you only succeeded with after 2 years. You can break it down into smaller chunks. So like I said, when you are just getting to grips with the basics, you just need to be able to see these landmarks to help you see the simple form of rib cage, pelvis, and head. So you break it down into this smaller chunk of anatomy, and now success is very close. I just need to know this much of the anatomy, and that is going to feed right into my drawing skills. And that's very motivating because it's like, oh, I learned it and now my drawings got better. The final do is do bring your anatomy into your figure drawing practice. You don't want to just do like, okay, now I'm doing anatomy, I'm thinking about anatomy, now I'm doing gesture. It's a totally separate thing. You want to start to bring your anatomical know-how into your sketching practice and all your practice, really. Let it inform what you're doing. That brings me on to the final don't, which is don't let anatomy ruin your figure drawing. So this is more subjective, but for me, sometimes I see artists who do very impressive drawings because they bring out so much anatomy, all these anatomical nuance and detail all over the figure. And then there's a lot of anatomy there, but the design of the shapes, that even the gesture have suffered because of it. Maybe the artist just has worked so hard on their anatomy, they can't help but want to show off all that know-how and ability, and then they bring so too much out, and then now the picture doesn't have, you know, an appealing composition, it doesn't have a great design and stuff like that, these more important things. If you're interested in learning a system for how to simplify the process of learning your gesture and your anatomy and your forms by bringing it down to the basics of each of those topics, we have a workshop for you, a free workshop. It's called How to Draw Life Beautifully. We've run it before and it's been very popular. So check out the link below and I hope to see you there. If you want to get into that fresh eyes challenge I mentioned earlier, the first tutorial video is here on the screen. Check it out even if you've seen it already. It's worth revising.